piece of mine.
The world's largest cruiserweight, Max Lemire, now in the ring in singles competition with probably the best cruiserweight in the world, second best cruiserweight in the world, Speedball Mike Bailey, who ducks underneath a lockup and goes to a headlock here on the much larger Max Lemire, shrugs him off like nobody's business, goes for a tackle, but please, Bailey, you might be very good, but Max is so much stronger. Bailey now leapfrog, drop down, Max hits the ropes, and drop kick, but not enough to take the big man off of his feet, and he knocks Bailey down one more time with a huge shoulder tackle. Scoops him up. And now going to the eyes, going to the nose, going to the mouth. Listen, we do what we have to do to win, but now he's going to cut off the air. Going to put on that chin lock. Mike Bailey has no choice but to go to the ropes or lose his head. And look at that huge forearm shot by Max to the lower back of Bailey. Bailey, of course, has very little chance in this matchup. Oh, we've seen this before as well. This beautiful abdominal stretch type maneuver in the ropes. Bailey has nowhere to go and is gonna, oh my goodness, that stretch, you get the ribs in pain, you get the lungs in pain, and you can see the look of pain on Mike Bailey's face, almost unsure what was that was like. You know what that's like? That's the world's strongest cruiserweight. Lemire now in the fireman's carry position with international star Bailey. Bailey with those elbows. Back to the rope. Goads Lemire in with a big boot. Lemire in overtime. Eats a second boot. Come on, Lemire. Bailey hits the ropes here. Catches a pump kick. Didn't get all of it. One more time. Catches them right in the side of the head this time. Blows by and a third pump kick. Still not enough to take the big man down off of his feet.
Come on!
Bailey yelling and telling him to get him. Throws a clothesline. Bailey now second rope and hits the second rope dropkick and finally enough to take the big man off of his feet. Bailey looks more surprised than I am, to be honest with you. I thought this would be easy work. Bailey now going to the second rope. What's he going for here? Maybe that shooter knees. Nope. Straight up double tie stomp. There's a pin. One. And no weight on the shoulders. Using both of those educated knees one more time. Still not enough to keep the big man down. What's Mike Bailey going for here? Maybe that running star? Nope. Rolling knees. Rolling thunder knees. One, two, still not enough. Maxime Lemire, too strong, too powerful, unwilling to give up. Bailey here, hoo-hoo. And now it's that moonsault double knees. My goodness, one, two, and... Mike Bailey's face used to winning with half of those maneuvers. But not a single one was enough to take down Max Lemire. Big PK, and you heard the scream from the world's largest cruiserweight. Come on, Max, get up! Get up, Max, you got this! Bailey going to the high rent district now, the top rope. Max gonna go after him. What's he going here? Catch him, Max. Easy catch by Max Lemire. Throws him up. Look at this. Look at this. Throws him up now into the suplex. Bailey straightened out. Giving him time to think about it. Easy peasy. He's going to drop him in this Falcon Arrow. Win the day. We're going to hit the pin. Baby. Here's the pin now. One, two, and... Referee Frank somehow only with a two count. And I might want to see a slow-mo repeat of that. Because I think that that should have been a victory, to be honest with you. I'm going to have to petition IWS management, I think. In fact, I'm taking a note of it on my phone right now. Lemire just has to hit him with the power bomb. What's he going for here now? Gut wrench? Whoa, Bailey slips behind. What's he going to go for here? Low bridge. But Lemire, so big, so strong, lands on his feet, no problem. Bailey, though, triangle moonsault, takes Lemire out completely. both men now worse for wear in this contest. As strong as Max Lemire is, of course, Speedball Mike Bailey, no slouch, one of the best talents in the entire world, a former IWS champion. What's Bailey going for here now? He's going to head back into the ring, leave Max to think about it. Lemire now back in the ring, Bailey climbing to the top rope one more time. Max Lemire very far away, not sure what Speedball's going for here, but Lemire catches him with a forearm. Bailey hesitated and Max Lemire took advantage, calling for the finish, climbing to the second, gonna destroy Speedball Mike Bailey right now. Easy peasy. Here comes the superplex, ladies and gentlemen, and that will be the end of this one. Oh my goodness, no. Bailey slides through. Powerbomb, what? No. What is happening here? Get up, Lemire. Get up, Lemire. Max Lemire starting to get up. He's on. Okay, you're fine. Oh, no. Could this be the Ultima weapon? Oh, my goodness. Kick out, Max. No way. No. 1, 2, and thank goodness. Oh, my God. I was legitimately worried, and clearly, Speedball Mike Bailey thought that was the end. I think we all did, folks. What's Speedball gonna go for? Maybe the tornado kick here? Nope. Huge lariat from Maxime Lemire. Turns him inside out. That's it. It's the power bomb. Oh, man. This has been quite the contest here on IWS Bloodstream, but here we go. The end. Oh, what's this? No. He drives him on his head. No. Kick out. Oh.
Je suis pris mis en taux pour la merveille. À 4 heures du matin, je croupillais dans ma cellule.
IWS Bloodstream features IWS veteran Mathieu Jaques taking on IWS relative newcomer but has been impressive of late Kevin Beru. Of course, he did lose to me and Maxime Lemire. But Mathieu Jaques is normally a brawler, but he is well versed in technical and catch wrestling. I used to actually train with him way back when, about 17 years ago. I do know that he has that catch background, and he's showing it off here. Kevin Beru generally get more clean cut around the edges. Gonna go to the rope there to force a break. Two. And Mathieu Saint-Jacques with a clean break. And little, there you go. Little pat on the back. A little bit, tell him, come on, kid. Show me what you got, huh? Mathieu Saint-Jacques, of course, one half of TDT. TDT, the most dominant tag team in IWS history. Kevin Beru really looking for that big win. Going for a cravat here, I think. Nope, it switches it into a top wrist lock. Take this time to point out that Kevin Beru is a graduate of the IWS Pro Dojo, our training center. Look us up on Facebook, IWS Training Center, if you'd like to learn how to wrestle here in Montreal. And I have to question giving attitude back to Mathieu Saint-Jacques. He might have been playing nice in wrestling, but when he gets mad, you do not want to be in his way. Collar and elbow tie up. Here's a side headlock by Mathieu. He cranks it in deep. Kevin now with some punches to force a break. We're gonna shoot off the ropes. What we got here? A tackle, and My God, Kevin just rebounded off the mat. Dropped down here by Kevin Beru. Leapfrog, but Matt just snatches him out of midair. Probably going for the Anderson. Nope. Dumps him with that Northern Light style mountain bomb. The veteran outsmarting the rookie there, and now giving it right back to him. And Beru answers with a beautiful drop kick right on the mush. And this game of jockeying for position back and forth just ended because Mathieu Saint-Jacques just ended Kevin Beru. 1-2. Not enough to keep the resilient rookie down. That is a patented maneuver of Mathieu Saint-Jacques, that spine buster. He delivers it with pinpoint accuracy and excellent efficiency. And right now, this is mostly efficient too, as we see the fish hook choke. Not quite as flashy, but definitely as effective from Mathieu Saint-Jacques. Saint-Jacques now with a front face lock, gonna go for that vertical suplex perhaps. Snap suplex right there, floats over. Nope, shoves him to the mat instead. And if you notice, he puts the forearm on the jaw instead of hooking the leg, folks. And that makes it so much easier. You're trying to get, sorry, so much harder, so much easier for Mathieu Saint-Jacques, rather. You're trying a shotgun-like strike. As I was saying, that forearm in the jaw makes it harder for you to kick out because you're trying to get your shoulders off of the mat. You don't want to raise that jawbone into a forearm like the one we just saw from Mathieu Saint-Jacques. Now Saint-Jacques a slap to the face, trying to wake up Beru, trying to inspire some fire, and there it is. He's gonna open up, rights, clubbing blows. Saint-Jacques, though, puts him right back into his place with that forearm strike. Gonna shoot him off the ropes, and big forearm to the kidney area. Let me tell you, those kidney strikes, those are deceptively painful, ladies and gentlemen, if you ever smacked yourself there before. One more time, here we go. And if you've ever walked into the corner of a table, maybe, you know just how painful that can be. Beru now off the ropes again. He's gonna fire back. Oh my goodness. Beru now firing up, giving all the strikes that he can. But Saint-Jacques cuts him off with a boot to the midsection. Saint-Jacques going here already now. Vertical suplex maybe to the outside. He's gonna do it. He's, oh my God, hangs him out to dry. No, Kevin Beru manages to reverse here. Slides out, but face lock position. What's this? Oh, double stomp into a senton spax press. 1-2 and only two. Only two. Kevin Beru's got to follow this up here with something. Maybe a dive, maybe some kind of those fancy aerial maneuvers, those high risk maneuvers. But ref tells him get back in the ring and Kevin takes out Mathieu Saint-Jacques all the way through those curtains. Referee Rene now telling the men to get back into the ring. Kevin Beru introducing Saint-Jacques to the ring the hard way. He's gonna go coast to coast now, charge him in. Hits that clothesline right over the top rope. Enziguri to the back of the head. What's he going for here? Big knee strike off the top rope. Is that enough? One. Only good for one from Mathieu Saint-Jacques. Both men down now, feeling the effects of this contest. Forearm shot. And again. Beru's got to do something here, but there you go. You don't want to stand there and exchange strikes with Mathieu Saint-Jacques, that's for sure. Saint-Jacques going for a pile driver again. Maybe that Gotch-style pile driver he's known for. He's got him up for it. There it is, Gotch-style pile driver. Deep hook on the leg, 1-2, and only good for two on Kevin Beru. But maybe, oh, Saint-Jacques going for it again. He will not be defeated. A second pile driver, that'll jam your spine right up. 1, 2, 3, and that's it. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Mathieu Saint-Jacques.
is me. I'm so woe. See me decked out from my head to my toe. Woe is me. I'm so woe. Everywhere I go, I'm a one-man show. I feel like a Hollywood star. Handful of pills, all black car. Rock guitar and 10 shots of whiskey. Got a chain on my neck and a massive...
Contest here for you on IWS Bloodstream. It's an IWS Canadian Championship match against the champion, Kevin Blanchard, taking on challenger, Leon Saver, the one-man show. It's a singles contest, of course, and right now, although Leon's taken a long time to get to the IWS, it looks like he wants nothing to do with Kevin Blanchard, the Canadian champion. Leon now charging in the corner. Look at that, he suckered him in. That's what it was. Those were mind games. Leon, of course, a thinking man wrestler with that right hand right in the corner there. Blanchard, no quit, fires right back at the challenger. Irish whip now from Leon. Sends Blanchard. Blanchard hopping right over. This is vintage Blanchard. Heads the other way, and Leon runs into a boot. Insegiri kicks his leg out of his leg. And calling for the Canadian Destroyer. Leon, though, shrugs him off, throws a line Kevin and manages to get out of it. Catches him right on the button with that super kick. One, two, only a two count from referee Frank. Blanchard a little bit unhappy with the speed at which Frank has been counting. Big chop here by Kevin Blanchard. And a right hand takes Leon right off of his feet. Leon now. Blanchard rather with a step there. Didn't catch all of it, but enough to the back of the head there on Leon Saver. Kevin Blanchard now climbing to the top rope. He's been known to use that double foot stomp to finish his opponents, but Leon, oh, slowly getting up. What's this here? Once again, suckers him in. Leon. Beautiful athletic calf kick takes Blanchard down, and Leon now with the pin. One. Only good for one, even with the deep leg hook. There's a reason Blanchard has been the Canadian champion for so long. Leon, though, is gonna stay on his man. This is smart wrestling here. Man can't breathe, he can't fight. We see the stomping there. Leon only giving as much quarter as he is forced to by the rules of professional wrestling. Leon, a huge chop now on Kevin Blanchard, but Kevin shrugs him off, and it just serves to make Leon more angry. But again, the fire of Kevin Blanchard, this never-say-die attitude, has been keeping him, well, in the winner's column. Leon now with a front face lock, a couple of shots, and beautiful snap suplex right in the middle of the ring, gonna float over, might be going for a pin. Back press here, one, two, and still not enough to keep Blanchard down. Blanchard, though, worse for wear on this one. We have seen him take some monumental beatings. Leon in firm control. And that's gotta feel good for somebody who is not, go for that snapmare driver maybe. Drops him right on his head, jams the neck, forearm across the jaw too, and still not enough, and you gotta wonder if Leon had hooked the leg, would that have been three? We'll take this opportunity right now to thank our sponsors, Prohibition. Go to prohibition.com for all your smoking accessory needs, rubs, barbecue. Speaking of smoking, some of the best smoked barbecue in the entire world. And, of course, Nutrizone for your supplement needs. You can follow us on Facebook and on social media as Duckline Enzigiri from Kevin Blanchard goes back to the top rope. What's he going for here? Big crossbody crushes him. One, two, and only two. As I was saying, you can follow us on social media at IWS Hardcore on Instagram and on Twitter. And make sure you follow us on Facebook as well, IWS International Wrestling Syndicate. Both of these men now need a respite from this grueling contest. Kevin Blanchard trying to build some kind of head of steam. Looks like he's measuring his shot here, and he's going to take it. Leon charges in. Kevin, though, rolls through, catches him in that schoolboy. And what's this? Knee, but no, Leon catches the knee. Trips him out there. Single leg takedown. Might be going for that sharpshooter he uses as a finishing maneuver. Catches it right in the middle of the ring. And this could be it. We might have a new champion. We might have a new champion. Ladies and gentlemen, look at the look on Blanchard's face, and while he may be one of the toughest people I've ever met, I think this might be too much for him, and he proves me wrong. I was wrong. Fine, I said it. He got the ropes. Good for him, but has the damage already been done is the real question. Look at that Leon now. It's like he's painted a bullseye on that lower back of Kevin Blanchard. Kevin usually doing the striking, but today it's all Leon in control. Might be going for that German suplex. No, he's going to block it, hit that elbow one more time. A third for good measure. A big one, create some separation. What's Blanchard going for here? Doesn't matter, he runs into a kitchen sink, that knee to the gut. And now Leon can say that he has hit the Canadian champion with everything and the kitchen sink. Irish whip to the ropes now, ducks one. One more time, goes for that. What's this? Canadian Destroyer out of nowhere. One, two, three, and that will do it. Ladies and gentlemen, the Canadian champion retains his championship with a Canadian Destroyer. And once again, your champion, IWS Canadian champion, Kevin Blanchard, with a strong showing, showing why he is such championship material. Thank you very much.
So for those unenlightened few of you who may not know who I am, allow me to educate you. My name is Black Dynamite. I am the man that when these lights are on and this camera is rolling and I speak, I give you a license to print money. When I step in that ring, I make the fans go black and I always keep them coming back. And when I walk the streets of this world, I know I look better than 99% of those people out there. And compared to the IWS roster, we might as well crank that up to a conservative 100%, because I know I look better than all those blood clots that never lifted a weight in their life. And I just so happen to be a two-time IWS world champion and current IWS tag team champion. So y'all have been asking me, where are your partners? Where's Carl Jepsen? Where's Giovanni? They're enjoying some well-earned time off back in the comfort of the Black Quebecois mansion, while I take care of business. Business means adding more gold to my bank account. So there are two champions I got my eye on. That's right, you Kevin Blanchard, you artificial aboriginal, and you Matt Angel, you little skinny fat Aaron Carter with AIDS little punk. Fact is, both of you have risen right to the top of my hit list, and I intend on taking your championships and wrecking your miserable careers. And I'm gonna show everyone why it's good to be black and it sucks to be you.
La 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 la.
Dynamite, one half of the IWS Tag Team Champions, a former IWS World Champion, and making short work of Fernando, chasing him after, outsmarting him one more time. Fernando, of course, is a rookie, in fact, Dynamite, a veteran, with that Gamangiri right to the front of the face. Big tackle from Black Dynamite. Look at this man, he is in phenomenal shape, ladies and gentlemen, and Fernando is certainly not in phenomenal shape right now, as he's being manhandled by Black Dynamite. Shoves him into the corner, gives him some boots, stomps in a mud hole, walks a dry. Referee Renee telling Black Dynamite to chill out, bro, take it easy. Front face lock now by Black Dynamite. Big suplex. Oh, into. Big power slam. One, two, and not enough to keep Fernando down. Fernando, of course, normally one half of Casanova Productions, his tag team partner, Giordano the producer, is on set right now, unfortunately. So Fernando is at it alone, goes up and over. Oh, shoves him in at a low blow, but I don't think the referee saw it. Referee Renee, a little bit confused. And unfortunately, he did not see it, and that's unfortunate for Black Dynamite, which means the match will continue. Senton bomb right on the apron, and Fernando in full control right now. Might have hurt his shoulder a little bit on that senton, I hope not. Seems okay. Big headbutt in between two men with very beautiful, luscious locks. Boot to the midsection. And one more. And one more. This was the opening that Fernando required. Front face lock by Fernando. Snap, suplex, floats over. One, two. Does not hook the leg. A rookie mistake from Fernando. You're not going to keep a world champion like Black Dynamite down without hooking that leg, putting all the weight on of his shoulders. Fernando now going for that swing and neck breaker, maybe. Shake, rattle, and roll style. And for the pin. One, two, back press. Only good for two on one half of the IWS Tag Team Champions, Black Dynamite. Dynamite, of course, one half of the Black Quebecois. His tag team partner, Carl Jepsen, recently had surgery, but will be able to compete. Big chop from Fernando, and that only looked like it made Black Dynamite mad. Black Dynamite, of course, in fantastic shape. A mixed martial arts background, as you can see with those strikes, and Fernando going to the eyes, the great equalizer. Stomps him down there. Does Black Dynamite on Fernando. Fernando's back of the head hit the mat real hard there, folks. And now what's Black Dynamite going for here? He's going to charge in. Big clothesline. Maybe one more. Kick to the knee. Fernando on. In trouble. Eats the boot right to the mush. Black Dynamite signaling for something here. Charges in. A big chop. Opens him up. And then, nope. Tried to reverse, but Black Dynamite cut him off at the pass. What's this here? Super kick right on the button. Good night, Irene. Two and only good for two. And I've got to say, I'm impressed with Fernando, the resiliency of this rookie here. Both of these guys, of course, tag team specialists, but Black Dynamite is a tenured veteran of the singles career. Oh, what's this? Maybe the Hammerlock DDT's been perfecting it. Hammerlock DDT, and that'll do it. One, two, and Black Dynamite still alive in this one. Very impressive from Black Dynamite. Also impressive, our sponsor is Prohibition. Go to Prohibition.com for all your smoking accessory needs, Rubs, Barbecue, NutriZone, and of course the IWS Training Center. IWS Pro Jojo, where you can get trained like Fernando, a graduate of the dojo, of course. says it's over. Going for maybe a pedigree here. No, but Black Dynamite dumps him with that back body drop unceremoniously to the floor. Fernando uses the ropes to stand. Black Dynamite, though, runs into an elbow. What's he gonna go for here? Spinning heel kick. Fernando is worse for wear, not looking so hot, not feeling so sexy. Looks like a fisherman into Fisherman Buster on the knee. Grabs a handful of hair, picks Fernando back up. Once again, front face lock. Brain Buster drops him right on the neck. One, two, and
what?
Kind of a cocky cover from Black Dynamite. I would expect better from the veteran, and Fernando able to get that shoulder up. This tag team specialist might not have the cardio to go all the way. Black Dynamite now with a double underhook. Fernando rolls through. Feet on the ropes now. One, two, but the referee saw it and caught it in time. Fernando now with a waist lock. Standing switch. Going for an O'Connor roll. He hits it. One. Oh, no. Into a schoolboy. One, two. And into a triangle choke transition here. Black Dynamite with a triangle choke on Fernando in the center of the ring. He might have to give. He might have to give. Remember that mixed martial arts background that I mentioned of Black Dynamite. And he's asleep. Good night, Irene. Fernando de la Cruz defeated by one half of your IWS Tag Team Champions, Black Dynamite, ladies and gentlemen, looking fantastic as ever.
Dans ma cellule, à coup de revolver, quelqu'un a crié, plein de meurtres dans ma prison, plein de meurtres dans la prison.
A high caliber contest here for IWS Bloodstream as one half of TDT, Mathieu Saint Jacques takes on the future of hardcore, Channing Decker, and these two boys are starting it up rough. And I can tell you, we're expecting a fight in this one. This is not gonna be a wrestling match, folks. This is gonna be a fight. Channing Decker, of course, fresh off of a tour of Japan and his ECW run, victories over the Green Phantom and Sexy Eddie, and challenging ECB Manny soon enough. Headlock to the ropes, here it is. Shoulder tackle, nobody goes. What's this wacky time? Saint-Jacques manages to complete the tackle. Of course, Saint-Jacques, one of the most dominant superstars in IWS history. With sentons like that, it's easy to see why Channing Decker now gonna create some separation. Might need a breather. TDT, of course, multiple time IWS Tag Team Champions, having recently lost those titles to the Black Quebecois. Now they're on the apron. Mathieu Saint-Jacques with that right hand. Channing with a boot goes low. Rakes the eyes, rubbing on the turnbuckle. For those of you at home, that just stings and burns. But Saint-Jacques shrugs it off, and I think he might be going for that pile driver on the apron, is he? Channing, though, no, gets his feet around the ropes. He's ducking, blocking. It doesn't work. Channing in phenomenal shape here, wearing these overalls like a filthy animal, picking Saint-Jacques up into the Death Valley driver position. What's he going for here? And oh my God! DVD straight on the apron, the hardest part of the ring. Mathieu Saint-Jacques worse for wear after taking that one. Channing willing to do whatever it takes to achieve victory in his quest to be the future of hardcore. Channing claims that nobody is as hardcore as he is in the IWS, and he's gonna prove that by winning the world title. What's he going for here? Channing now. Look at that. I just said that he was going to be future of hardcore and already going for the lumber. Throwing two chairs in the ring. Nope, that's not enough. He's got a bunch more in his hands. Putting them on the ground here. And what's this? Winds them up. Flat of the back right with a chair. That'll drive the air right out of Mathieu Saint-Jacques' lungs. And Mathieu Saint-Jacques, of course, a very, very well-known brawler. Oh, no. Oh, no. Not this. Oh! Could have busted a larynx there. Close the windpipe. As I was saying, a prolific brawler is Mathieu Saint-Jacques, but right now, Channing Decker is showing him that he is no slouch. Pulling out, what's this here, a particle board, it seems. Big piece of wood, drops it right on him. Going for the chair now, he's creating a sandwich. Oh my god, give me some more. As he drives that chair right into that piece of wood, that plywood there. Now what's Channing got in mind here? As this man, Channing has gone to wars with the likes of ECW originals like Sabu, and he has picked up tricks of the trade for every single beating he has taken, now making some kind of structure, some kind of pain device. I don't even know what to call it. Some kind of torture chamber, a playground? Regardless of what it is, I don't like Mathieu Saint-Jacques' odds as he struggles to his feet. But Mathieu Saint-Jacques, of course, is double tough. You cannot count him out, but here's Channing now. He's got a chair. He's got a chair. This is never a good idea. And Saint-Jacques, though, cuts him off at the pass. Takes a chair of his own. Oh my goodness, revenge is a dish best served with a chair. And you can hear the crack of that chair across Channing's back all through the arena here, folks. I'm sure you heard it at home. This match, typical of the kind of exciting hardcore action you see here on IWS Bloodstream. We invite you to check out our social media if you like what you see. Channing Decker, though, has a different idea. And then we talked about that Sabu-style chair lounge. So, of course, you can check us out on social media, fans, IWS Hardcore on the Twitter and the Instagram machines. What's this here? Channing might be going for an Arabian Facebuster made famous by Sabu. It's an elbow drop instead with the chair. And speaking of elbow, Mathieu Saint-Jacques caught that right in the elbow. Not enough to keep him down, but you can tell by the look of pain on the man's face. See that elbow? That arm might be useless. That arm, he might not have access to that anymore. And Channing is going to take advantage and just lay it down on him. And then look at this, puts a choke on him. Referee Renee's going to have to get in there before this he ends this man's career. And we've got a crossface now, a crossface with the chair right across the jaw of Saint-Jacques. And my goodness, that cannot be comfortable, ladies and gentlemen. Saint-Jacques now desperately reaching to the ropes and manages to throw Channing off. Lucky for him, that shoulder, that arm, they might be done. One. Only good for a one count, though. Saint-Jacques, like I said, double tough. Somebody who you just cannot keep down. Look at him, he loves it. Channing now with another evil idea, setting up that chair in the corner. Might try to ram Saint-Jacques into it. Might try to whip him into it. Whatever it is, it didn't work. Channing smartly, though, goes to the next chair, no problem. And again, that chair shot. And he's going to put that chair. He's going to try again in another turnbuckle. This one works. We're okay. And here we go. Maybe ram his head into it, going for this bulldog-type maneuver. And Saint-Jacques puts the brakes on. Here comes Channing. Saint-Jacques meets him with that forearm. I have felt that on many an occasion. It's not fun. What's this? Big Anderson-style spine buster, and Saint-Jacques has taken back control in this singles contest on IWS Bloodstream. Saint-Jacques now with a surge of adrenaline running through his veins like he can feel no pain. But you can better believe this is taking a toll on both of these combatants, both of these warriors. Saint-Jacques might be setting up for that pile driver now. He's got one of the most beautiful pile drivers in the business, but Channing now reverses it. Saint-Jacques eats a backdrop, lands on the hip and on that bad elbow. But Channing gets caught again. Saint-Jacques was playing possum. Pile driver spikes Channing, but Channing shrugs it off. He says no, and he's hardcore. Hardcore Decker now, but Say Jaques also. Is he gonna do it again? Is he gonna do it again? He's got him up. He's got him up. And what comes up must come. Gotch style. Here it comes. Down. Gonna float over back press here. One, two, and not enough to keep the future of hardcore down. No leg hook there, unfortunately. Saint Jaques, too tired, was not able to achieve that full cover. You have to wonder if he did have the weight on the shoulders, would that have been enough for three? But Saint Jaques, in his brawler's mind, in that lumberjack maniacal line, he is gonna go and look for something else to use under the ring. What's he got here? Folks, he has pulled out a piece of guardrail. And this might be a no-fans taping, which makes sense for him to use it, but either way, that is pure steel. That'll rip you up, cut you up, and my God, that'll break a rib in no time. Both of these men now worse for wear, showing the bruises and battered bodies of this contest. But neither man willing to cede an inch. These two are hardcore. They're in a ton of pain. If you need to manage your pain, you go over to Prohibition.com. They'll hook you up with plenty of good stuff. And if you got that hunger in your tummy, we want you to check out Rub's Barbecue. Chanting now in the corner, that big capo kick. Saint Jaques spills to the outside, maybe for a breather. He's on that table though. What's this? Oh my God! Channing Decker with a leg drop through that plywood right on the back of St. Jaques' head, and if he's not out cold, I don't know how this man is still standing. Channing now rolling St. Jaques back into the ring, going for the pin, and this is just elementary. Somehow, though, Mathieu St. Jaques manages to kick out. Folks, that is a testament to the hardcore attitude here in the IWS. Only the strongest survive. Only the toughest athletes will grace our ring. And these two men putting on a war to show you why. Channing Decker now setting up that guardrail with bad intentions. St. Jaques, though, kicks him and puts his head through that chair in the corner. What's this here now? Maybe going for that Anderson Spinebuster. The Alabama Slam, perhaps. Alabama! Oh, and the back of Channing Decker's head hitting off that guardrail. They broke the guardrail with his body. St. Jaques, Texas Cloverleaf. He's won many a match with this one, but I think Channing Decker is out cold, and referee Renee calling for the bell. Channing would not give up, but the body was not willing, and your winner, Mathieu St. Jaques.